welcome to this tutorial. My name is Gael. I am the main author at authorityhacker.com, a site about building authority websites and inbound marketing in general. In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to piggyback ride your competitor's content marketing effort so that you can find the best content ideas you should focus a lot of effort on and that you have a very good chance to rank for, because we're gonna be observing your competitors and see how well they did. So let's just get started. So the first step of the tutorial starts here in your dashboard in Ahrefs. Once you have added your website in here, then you'll see it in here and you can just click through to your kind of dashboard and your stats for your website. And what I like to look at is I like to look at my top 10 competitors. And the first task we're gonna have to do is to make a list of these competitors in a spreadsheet. So what I like to do is I like to take these 10 and then I like to actually look at their competitors themselves. So I just go in the Site Explorer overview and I just open the competitors of my competitors and I build a massive list, which I have prepared here already because that would take a lot of time. Feel free to create a list of up to 50 competitors because it's going to be quite important, and the more competitors you have, the more content ideas you're going to be able to brainstorm. Another way I like to use to find competitors of mine and just the competitors of my competitors is to go on Google and to use the related advanced query. So that would be like authorityhacker.com. And then instead of searching for that query, Google is actually going to come up with sites that it thinks are similar to my site. So, you know, Content Champion, Warrior Forum, Authority Blog Starter Kit, which we saw in Ahrefs as well. And so using these two tactics, you can really easily build a list of up to 50 competitors, which I think is what you should be aiming for. So I'll let you build that list of competitors. Feel free to pause the video now and let's get to the next step now. All right, I'm just going to assume that you put together your list of competitors. For my example here for Authority Hacker, I just put 40 together, but I recommend you go as far as 50. Even a lot more if you really want to brainstorm a lot of content for your brand. It just depends how much content you're creating and how much you want to create in that one brainstorm. So now that we have these, what we're going to do is we're going to select all of them and copy them. And then before we go into the batch analysis in Ahrefs, which is going to tell us how strong these domains are compared to us, we need to know what we're comparing to. And what we're comparing to is our own domain. So in my case, authorityhacker.com, in your case, your website. And when you put your domain name in your Site Explorer in Ahrefs, you can see that it gives you a domain rating number. And the domain rating is basically an evaluation that Ahrefs makes of how strong your domain is and how competitive it can be in search results. And that's really the base of this research, is that we're going to try to find content on sites that are roughly as strong as us that rank well in Google. Because if they are as strong as us and rank well in Google, well, the chances are, if we create the same kind of content for our site, we also rank pretty well. So we know that our number here for Authority Hacker is 50. And what we're going to do now is we're going to go in Labs and then Batch Analysis. That's the tool we're going to use now. And I have it opened in a new tab. So go there and then paste your list of domains here, right? And you just click on Start Analysis. And what Ahrefs is going to do is it's going to do a rough analysis of all these domains and it's going to give us their domain rating. So we see that we are at 50, and let's look at how strong these competitors are. And you can see the domain rating column here, which gives you the number of the competitor. What I like to do is I like to sort it out per number. So you can see that, for example, people below me are these people. So from nishaeu.com to mastermindblogger.com. People that are equal to me are from loranly.com to 50 to wpleaders.com, and all these people are above me. So now we know that if we want to do well, we're going to want to pick a site that's, you know, roughly equal to you. Now, obviously, this number is very approximative, and so usually I like to pick sites that are within 5 of me. So usually, since I'm at 50, I would be looking at 45 to 55 usually. So like from Shia Baxter, or even from Shia Baxter, or even like Smart Internet Lifestyle up until AmelineAndrews.com. And I'm actually gonna pick that one for that case. That would be a little bit more on the difficult side because they are domain rating 55, so they're a little bit higher than my domain. But I just like picking that one because I know that site has a lot of content, so it's gonna explain the case nicely. So let's just pick that domain. And then what I like to do is I like to go in Positions Explorer. So if you go on top of Ahrefs, you can go in Positions Explorer, and then I'm gonna open it in a new tab, and I'm going to paste that domain. So amylineandrews.com. And what Ahrefs does is it finds all the keywords that this domain ranks for. And it gives you a little bit of an idea of like the evolution of the organic keywords and the number of keywords they rank for. And usually when a curve's going up, it's usually a good thing. It just means that site's doing well with SEO. And so, you know, if you were to copy them, they're about the same strength as you and they're getting better, then most likely you're gonna do better yourself. And so I like to go in top pages. And once we have the top pages loaded, Ahrefs is going to show us the pages on that domain that receive the most traffic. And you can see it gives you a little traffic index here with a number. So the higher the number, the more traffic the page is getting, probably. Obviously, Ahrefs doesn't have a Google Analytics for these domains, so it's an approximative number, but it's pretty reliable. And also, you can see the number of keywords this page is ranked for. So in that case, you can see that this how to make money blogging page, and if I expand it, I can see that it ranks for how to make money blogging, number two, make money blogging, number two, how to make money with a blog. Basically, all these big keywords that have a lot of search volume, which you can see here, and maybe it would be interesting for me to create such content. Actually, I do have that content on my site, how to make money blogging. And if I wanted to, you know, brainstorm this keywords idea, I would literally just go on these pages and look at all these keywords. So like how to start a blog would probably be a good one for me to create. How to start a blog has 49,500 visits per month and she ranks number 7, which is pretty good already. So I would be able to go and grab these ideas. So what I like to do is I like to, for example, open these URLs and start a new tab in my spreadsheet and just put the URL so I can get back to it later and see what it's about, and then put one core keyword for it. So I'm just gonna go back into my page, and the main keyword here, obviously, since the volume is 49,500, is how to start a blog. So I would just put it here, and I would just keep going through that competitor's web pages and find the keywords that they rank for and just the content concepts that are interesting. So if I keep going through that list, you know, maybe how to write an ebook is a great keyword as well that I can target. And, you know, I see she ranks number one for 1,300 searches per month. That's a pretty good one. So I would just grab that one as well and I would put it in my spreadsheet. And basically the tactic is to do that for all your competitors and to build a massive list of content ideas. So let me just grab that keyword as well. And so when you get to a drawing board and you're like, what kind of content do I need to write? Well, you have that massive list of content ideas and just pieces of content that your competitors that have the same level of domain authority as you are ranking for, and you can just pick from there a topic that you can write about and have a pretty good chance of ranking as long as you also do the effort of building the same kind of links. And so the beauty of Ahrefs is that once you've brainstormed all these content ideas, I only have two here, but you know, going through the 50 competitors, imagine that I get 5 ideas per competitors, I could get 250 content ideas. So I could really get going for a while. And then once you create that piece of content, what I recommend is that you actually go back to your Site Explorer and put the piece of content that you have picked up from your competitor and look at the kind of links that they have and try to replicate these links. So you have the same domain level metrics. Now you're gonna try to replicate the same page level metrics. So getting the backlinks, getting the social shares, getting all of that. So I'm just getting Ahrefs to do the research right now. And now that it came up with it, you can see there are 85 backlinks from 38 domains, and there is a lot of Pinterest shares. It's interesting. And so I would literally just go in the links here. I would probably just focus on the dofollow links. So I would filter for one backlink per domain so that it just removes duplicate domains. And then look at the dofollow links only. And you can see there are 26 of these. And then I could just literally open each of them and see where I could get a backlink. That one is a little bit weird. I'm not too sure about that one. So I'm not going to go too much into that. But maximize social business. That's a blog post written by my friend Dave Schneider. I actually know that person. And so I could, I could definitely ask him how he got on this site and try to get on this site as well as a guest post, I imagine. And that's a domain rating 38. As you can see, per my Ahrefs toolbar, you can find the Ahrefs toolbar if you go in lab and you go in SEO toolbar. So that's what I have here. So you can see it's DR58. So that would definitely help me if I got a link from here. Latina homemaker. Let's just look at what kind of links she got, but like it's for moms. I'm not exactly a mom, so that would be pretty hard for me to get. You won't be able to get all of them, but you'll be able to get a bunch of them. Now, the good news is, well, you know that that piece of content ranks for how to start a blog, right? So you can actually go back on Google, type that keyword, and actually she should be ranking pretty high. I mean, she's not the first one, but she's, actually I can see her. She's here, sorry. And what I could do is I could actually reverse that process for pretty much everyone ranking for that keyword. And in that case, that's a homepage, so I'm not gonna go for that. I usually like to go for deep pages, but something like blogging basics, how to start a blog, that kind of page I could definitely reverse engineer. So I can do exactly the same thing that I've been doing with the competitor I copied and just look at their links and try to replicate them. Now, if you do that for the top 10 on Google or even the top 20, you're gonna be able to find a bunch of link opportunities. And if you run after these link opportunities, sorry, let me just go on that screen. If you run after these link opportunities for your new piece of content that you want to rank for that keyword, you will eventually have better metrics than the competitor you've copied. So you have the same level of domain level metrics and you have better metrics on a page level. And as a result, you'll be able to outrank these people and get even better results than they get. And the good news is by running through that process, your domain rating is going to increase because you're increasing the number of links to your site. And in turn, that's going to increase your domain rating, which means that then you can go back to your competitor list and your batch analysis. And then, well, you might be 55 at that point. So I might be able to take the people that are in the 60s and so on. So like, it's not here, but like someone that's maybe like 55, I could definitely go after them. Let me just take this. Yeah. So I could go after shoutmeloud.com after that if I increase my domain rating a little bit. So that's the power of this technique. You can really use it to grow your SEO traffic over time doing white hat SEO. You just reverse engineer the top content, you create something better, you get the links, and then as your domain rating increases, you have more targets that you can reverse engineer, create more content, and keep growing. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope this made sense. And if you want more tutorials like this one, go on authorityhacker.com, that's my website. And I release a bunch of blog posts and tutorials talking about everything inbound marketing and building authority sites. I'll see you later.